Dear students, in the present lecture, we are going to discuss various definitions under Income Tax Act 1961. In the present lecture, we will focus on definition like capital and revenue receipt, capital and revenue expenditure, capital asset, short term capital gain, long term capital gain, business, profession, vocation. Firstly, I would like to discuss capital and revenue receipt. Receipt by way of income. So we are considering here two types of receipt, capital receipt and revenue receipt. Capital receipt is the receipt which is occurred due to sale of fixed asset, long term investment. On the other hand, revenue receipt means a receipt occurred because of our day to day working of the business. The object of income tax is to tax on revenue receipt unless specified exempted. On the other hand, capital receipt are not chargeable to tax except when specifically provided in the act. From this, we extract that revenue receipt are taxable if revenue receipt of taxable of the business if they are specifically not exempted. Generally, capital receipt are not taxable except certain circumstances. A receipt in substitution of a source of income is a capital receipt, while a receipt in substitution of income is a revenue receipt. In simple, there are two types of receipts: revenue receipt and capital receipt. Revenue receipt arises because of our operation taken in our business, and capital receipt arises due to sale of long term investments or fixed asset on which gain has been incurred. An amount received as a compensation of certain rights under an agreement is a capital receipt. That is very important. Amount received as a compensation because of transfer of our rights to other, that is capital receipt. An amount received under an agreement as compensation for loss of future profit is a revenue receipt. From this definition, we learn that capital receipt and revenue receipt. Capital receipt is arising due to transfer of our rights, and revenue receipt is arising due to loss of future profit. Now we are going to discuss another definition as per Income Tax Act, that is capital and revenue expenditure. In accountancy, we know that there are basically two types of expenditure: capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. But for that income tax purpose, we are defining here capital and revenue expenditure computing taxable income, normally revenue expenditure incurred for the purpose of earning income is deductible from revenue receipt unless the law provides specific rules to disallow such expenditure wholly or partly. For that purpose, we are focusing here head of business and head of business. There are five heads of income, of which business or profession head. In business, a businessman incurred a day-to-day expenditure for earning income, that is called as revenue expenditure. Revenue receipt means receipt arrived due to business operations. In case of business, we can find out profit of a business by using formula revenue receipt minus revenue expenditure. Here, revenue expenditure is incurred for getting revenue income. Capital expenditure is not deductible while computing taxable income unless law expressly so provides. Generally, capital expenditure is disallowed. So, it is not deductible except certain circumstances. Neither the capital expenditure nor revenue expenditure has been defined in the Act. There is no definite definition of revenue expenditure and capital expenditure in the income tax. However, from certain facts and circumstances of each case and from the judicial decisions, the following are the general principles to be kept in mind. Firstly, capital expenditure is a non-recurring expenditure. A question may be asked in our examination, capital expenditure is a dot dot expenditure. So answer is capital is a non-recurring expenditure. On the other hand, revenue expenditure is a recurring expenditure. For your understanding, I am taking one example. Suppose building purchased of rupees 50 lakh, that is capital expenditure. This is not occurring again and again. Those expenses which are not occurring again and again called as non-recurring expenditure or capital expenditure. Hence, we are not purchasing building again and again. That's why building is purchased generally for a particular purpose, that is capital expenditure. Another example of revenue expenditure, suppose salary paid to employees in the month of July. We are also required to pay that salary in August, in September, in October, like this. So, salary is a recurring expenditure. So, it is a revenue expenditure. Capital expenditure incurred in acquiring, extending, or improving a fixed asset. Capital expenditure is incurred for acquisition of asset. For example, land, machinery, furniture. Capital expenditure is incurred for extending or improving of a fixed asset. So, for example, building extended, that is capital expenditure. On the other hand, Revenue expenditure is incurred in the normal course of business as a routine expenditure to meet day-to-day expenses of the business. Revenue expenses are incurred. Capital expenditure incurred for enduring benefits. Capital expenditure done today is giving benefits for future. Revenue expenditure is consumed within a previous year. Revenue expenditure means expenditure which is incurred in the previous year. We may call it income year. Capital expenditure makes improvement with the earning capacity of business. Because of capital expenditure, a business house will improve its income or improve its earning capacity because of we have invested too much amount in various fixed asset. Revenue expenditure maintains the profit making capacity of business. For maintaining profit earning capacity, revenue expenditures are incurred. So question may be asked like this: capital expenditure is incurred for improving dot dot. Alternatives may be profit capacity, capital capacity, earning capacity, status. The correct answer is earning capacity. On the other hand, revenue expenditure are incurred for maintaining profit making capacity. Then another definition, capital asset. Here this definition is given in section 2 clause 14 of the Income Tax Act. Here capital asset means property of any kind. Any kind of property is called as capital asset. It may be movable or immovable. Movable means a property which can be transferable from one place to another place. For example, computer. For example, motor vehicle. Immovable property. Immovable property means a property which is not transferable. For example, land, building. Held by SEC. It may or may not be connected with his business or profession. Capital asset means asset of any kind. It may be movable it may be immovable. Capital asset include all kinds of property, movable, immovable, tangible or intangible. Tangible asset means which are visible. Intangible assets are the assets which are not visible. Tangible asset, for example, furniture, motor vehicles. Intangible asset, for example, goodwill, copyrights, fixed or current. Hence, capital assets include property of every kind like movable, immovable, tangible, intangible, fixed or current. Even the leasehold rights, partner shares in a firm, a manufacturing right, etc. are considered to be capital assets. Leasehold rights is coming under capital asset, partner shares in firm coming under capital asset, manufacturing right is also coming under capital asset. But it is necessary to remember that capital assets do not include the following. Firstly, we broadly said that this type of property included under capital asset. But now we are focusing the following assets are not called as capital asset, that are given as any stock in trade, consumable stores, raw materials held for the business purpose. Stock in trade, raw materials held for business, these are not capital asset. Personal effects, that is say movable property, including wearing apparel, means costly clothes, and furniture, but excluding jewelry. Personal effects, that is called a halo effects. Everyone is trying to improve his or her personality by taking costly wearing apparel, furniture. That is called as personal effects. These are assets held for personal use by the SEC or the any member of his family dependent on him. Here wearing apparel, furniture is not coming under costly furniture, is not coming for measuring capital asset. Personal effects, that is to say movable property including wearing apparel and furniture but excluding jewelry held for personal use by the SEC or any member of his family dependent on him. A motor car, TV, VCR is regarded as personal effects and not treated as capital asset. Those assets which are used for personal effect, that are not called as capital asset. For example, wearing apple held for personal use, furniture held for personal use, motor car held for personal use, TV or VCR used for personal use is not capital asset. These are not capital assets. But jewelry is a capital asset. Take into account, jewelry is a capital asset. We are discussing here what are the assets which are not included under capital asset. Here, for personal effects, wearing apparel, furniture, TV, VCR, motor car, that have personal effects. So these assets are not considered as capital assets. Also, capital asset do not include agricultural land, which is situated in urban area. That is not called as capital asset. Capital bonds issued by the central government. Gold bonds issued by the central government, namely 6.5% gold bonds 1977, 7% gold bond 1980, national defense gold bonds 1980, special bearer bonds 1991. These are the property not coming under the capital asset. Now we are concerned with another definition, that is short term capital asset under section 2 clause 42A. Previously we discussed a capital asset. Now we are discussing short term capital asset. In order to define a specific capital asset as short term or long term, capital assets are two types, short term capital asset and long term capital asset. Here, capital asset or short term capital, capital asset as short term or long term, all such assets have been classified into two groups. As under, we have classified here asset into short term capital asset and long term capital asset. Presently, we are focusing only short term capital asset. The short term capital asset has two group, group 1 and group 2. Group 1, shares of a company. Group 1 includes shares of a company, any other listed security, units of unit trust of India, units of mutual fund specified under section 10 clause 23D. These are called financial assets. This is group 1. Group 2, other capital asset. Those assets covered under group A, excluding that asset, remaining assets are called as other capital assets and recorded under group 2. Hence, financial assets are coming under group 1 and other assets, capital assets, are coming under group 2. In case of group 1, of capital assets, if they are held by SEC for not more than 12 months immediately preceding the date of their transfer, they are called short-term capital assets. In case of group 1, capital asset. In case of financial asset or group 1 capital asset, if these assets are held by the SEC for not more than 12 months and immediately transfer, they are called that short-term capital asset. Short-term capital asset which are held by an SEC not more than 12 months. In other words, the assets called as capital asset. The capital assets into bracket financial assets which are held by SEC not more than 12 months immediately preceding the date of their transfer, they are called as short-term capital assets. Group 2. If the capital asset, if they are held by SEC for not more than 36 months immediately preceding the date of their transfer, they are called as short-term capital asset. So here are two views. First view is related with financial asset or capital assets. The examples of which are given above. Period is considered for that not more than 12 months. For group 2, we are considering other capital asset or capital asset other than financial assets. Here, the period is to be considered not more than 36 months. Another definition, that is long-term capital asset section 2 clause 42A. If one thing is okay, another thing will become okay. If you properly understand what is meant by short-term capital asset, so it is simple to understand long-term capital asset. In order to define a specific capital asset as short-term or long-term, all such assets have been classified into two groups as. This matter is also taken as it is in short-term capital gain. Group A, 1 is considered here again, which is shown under short-term. Group A, I have also explained group A under short-term capital asset, also again explaining this group under long-term capital asset as it is. Shares of a company, any other listed securities, units of unit trust of India, units of mutual funds. These are the financial assets. We are considering the same thing under short-term capital asset. Group 2, other capital asset. Here group 2, other capital asset means the capital asset excluding financial asset. This is also already discussed under short-term capital asset. In short-term capital asset, we see that group A, in group A, we stated that the asset held not for more than 12 months. That statement is taken as under, but change is taken place here, more than 12 months. In short-term capital asset, we under group, we say that not more than 36 months. Here long-term asset, we may say that more than 36 months. So, in relation to long-term capital asset, I am discussing these things again. In order to define a specific capital asset as short-term or long-term, all such assets have been classified into two groups. Group 1, it covers shares of a company, any other listed security, units of unit trust of India, units of mutual funds. These are financial asset. Group 2, other capital asset. Now we are approaching towards the long-term capital asset. In case of group 1 of capital asset, if they are held by the SEC for more than 12 months, immediately preceding the date of their transfer, they are called as long-term capital asset. In case of second group of capital asset, here, capital asset, if they are held by the SEC for more than 36 months, immediately preceding the date of their transfer, they are called long-term capital asset. In short, we may divide these things in simple manner. Short-term capital asset under these two categories are financial assets and second, other capital asset. For short-term capital, the financial asset which are not held by SEC more than 12 months immediately preceding the date of transfer. Other asset which are held not more than 36 months. Another type, long-term asset, group A. If these asset held more than 12 months, that is group 1, that is called as long-term capital asset. Other asset, if these asset are capital asset are held by SEC immediately preceding the date of transfer more than 36 months, that is called as long-term capital asset. Business. In general sense, business means dealing with specific activity continuously. The purpose of business is to earn a profit. But for income tax purpose, the business is defined as any trade, commerce, or manufacture, or adventure, or concern in the nature of trade, commerce, or manufacture. This is the definition of business given as per income tax. Business is any real and organized activity. Business is not fictitious activity, it is real activity. It is organized activity carried for the purpose of profit. In general sense, business means any activity carried on for profit. Any activity carried on for profit is called as business. In order to verify whether transaction involves a business, the following test may be applied. Whether the transaction involves the purchase or sale of commodity or service. Where purchase occurred or sales occurred, that is called as transaction, that is called as business. Whether there was any intention of earning profit, even an isolation transaction can be considered as business or an adventure in the nature of trade if the circumstances justify that conclusion. For example, purchase of a plot with an ultimate intention of disposing it of a profit. That activity is also called as business. That is the test of business. Another definition, profession. Profession means an occupation. Profession means an occupation requiring to use intellectual skill or manual skill or both. Definition of profession is occupation requiring to use intellectual skill or manual skill or both. For examples, doctors, engineers, advocates, chartered accountant, doing profession, they are called as professionals. Profession does not include production, purchase and sale of goods and services to earn a profit. In profession, we are rendering services, but the intention is not to earn a profit. So, profession does not include any kind of production. It does not include purchase and sale of goods. Profession makes use of their special knowledge and skills to solve the problems of common men and thereby earn the livelihood. The purpose of profession is to provide special knowledge or skills for solving problems of common men. The prime objective of profession is to service and not to the profit. And last definition, that is vocation. Vocation is an activity which is performed to earn a livelihood. It is a way of living for which one has required a special fitness. The examples of vocation are musicians, dancers, singers, brokers, brokerage, painters, etc. Vocational does not involve any organized activity as in the case of business. For income tax purpose, the technical difference between business, profession or vocation is of little importance as all of these are covered under the head income from business or profession. Last three definitions, that is business, profession, vocation. In these definitions, there is a silent change. There is a technical difference, but on an average, they are covered under the same head called as income from business or profession. So, this is all about the definitions regarding various items. In the present lecture, we discussed the definition of capital assets, short-term capital asset, long-term capital asset, profession, business, vocation. In this way, I am concluding here my speech. Thank you for patiently listening.